Hello students, a very warm welcome to you. I am Mrs. Kavita Modi. Today we are going to continue chapter 15, perimeter and area. In this chapter, our topic is area. Now we learn how to find the area of some closed figures. Let's begin with does the term area mean? The measure of surface enclosed by a closed figure is called area. In rectangle ABCD, the amount of space inside a shape is called the area. A line is called 1D, as it moves in one dimension only. So whenever we use to find perimeter, we take the total length. So perimeter is one dimension. Now let's make a line of 1 cm. If we move this 1D line in distance of 1 cm like this way, we formed a 2D shape. And all the surface that we covered along the way is the area of that shape. So area is basically length multiplied by distance we moved. That is breadth. Thus, area is equal to length multiplied by breadth. Now put the value 1 cm multiplied by 1 cm. Now do the multiplication. 1 times 1 is just 1. But what about centimeter multiplied by centimeter? Centimeter multiplied by centimeter gives us square centimeter, which we can write like this, using a 2 as an exponent. And we read this centimeter squared. The basic unit of length is centimeter. So area will be centimeter multiplied by centimeter, which gives us centimeter square. So what if our length is in meter? Yes, the area will be meter square. If our line is 1 kilometer long and we moved it a kilometer, we have a square kilometer of area. So whenever you see units as square centimeter, square meter or square kilometer, you know it is the measurement of two-dimensional quantity, that is area. That means we can use square units to measure any area. Now, let us look at the formulas for the area of rectangle, square and triangle. Let's begin with rectangle. To find the area of rectangle, we have to do multiplication of two sides, that is length and breadth. So the formula look like this. Area of rectangle is equal to length multiplied by breadth. It is also written just the first letter of each word. That is, area of rectangle is equal to L multiplied by B. And we know that in a square, all the sides are equal in length. That means length is equal to breadth. So area of square is equal to side multiplied by side. Or we can say that side square. If we cut this rectangle exactly in half along a diagonal line from opposite corner, we get a triangle. And this triangle is exactly half of the rectangle. That means the area of triangle is exactly the half of the rectangle. So area of triangle is equal to 1/2 of length multiplied by breadth. But in triangle, instead of length and breadth, we are going to use base and height. So area of triangle is equal to 1/2 of base multiplied by height. Or in short form, we have to write it as 1/2 of in bracket B multiplied by H. Let's try using these formulas with a few examples so to see how it works. Number 1. Vinit wants to polish the floor of a room which is 140 cm long and 120 cm wide. The charges of polishing the floor is Rs. 52 per square meter. What will be the cost of polishing the floor of the room? Now tell me what we have to find, area or perimeter? Yes, area, because here we are not polishing the boundary, but we are polishing the entire area covered by the floor. And see the charges of polishing the floor, which is Rs. 52 per square meter. And square meter is the unit of area. So we have to find the area. How? Let's see. Length of the floor is equal to 140 cm. Now look at the question carefully. Length and width is given in cm. And the cost is given in square meter. So let's convert 140 cm into meter. We know that 100 cm is equal to 1 meter. So 140 cm is equal to 1.40 meter, which is equal to 1.4 meter. and breadth of the floor is equal to 120 cm. If we convert them into meter, we get 1.20 meter, which is equal to 1.2 meter. And the cost of polishing the floor of the room we have to find out. We know that area of floor is equal to length multiplied by breadth. Now put the value 1.4 meter multiply 1.2 meter. Now do the multiplication. 1.4 multiply 1.2, we get 1.68. But what about meter multiply by meter? Meter multiply by meter gives us square meter. And square means 2, which we can write like this, using 2 as an exponent. And we read this 1.68 meter squared. Now, we will find out the cost of polishing the floor of the room. If cost of 1 square meter floor polishing is rupees 52, therefore cost of 1.68 square meter floor polishing is equal to rupees 52 multiply 1.68. Now do the multiplication, we get rupees 87.36. So the cost of polishing the floor of the room is rupees 87.36. The next is question number 2. A carpet is 6 meter long and 4.5 meter wide. Find the area of the carpet. Also find the cost of the carpet if it costs rupees 45 per square meter. See, in this question, length of carpet is equal to 6 meter, breadth of carpet is equal to 4.5 meter and area of carpet we have to find out and the cost of the carpet also we have to find out. We know that area of carpet is equal to length multiplied by breadth. Now put the value 6 meter multiply 4.5 meter. Now do the multiplication. 6 multiply 4.5, we get 27. And meter multiply by meter, we get square meter. So area of carpet is equal to 27 square meter. Now we will find out the cost of the carpet. If cost of 1 square meter carpet is rupees 45, therefore cost of 27 square meter carpet is equal to rupees 45 multiplied by 27. Now do the multiplication, we get rupees 1215. So the cost of 27 square meter carpet is rupees 1215. Let us solve one more question. Question number 3. A square park is to be watered. If one side of the park is 4.2 meter, find the area to be watered. See, in this question, side of square park is equal to 4.2 meter and area of the park to be watered we have to find out. We know that area of square park is equal to side multiplied by side. Now put the value 4.2 meter multiply 4.2 meter. Now do the multiplication. 4.2 multiply 4.2 we get 17.64 and meter multiply by meter we get square meter. So area of a square park is equal to 17.64 square meter. Thus area to be watered is 17.64 square meter. Next is question number 4. Which playground has bigger area? One that measures 50 meter by 40 meter or the other that measures 75 meter by 20 meter. See, in this question, first we find the area of both the playground and then we compare which one is bigger area. So write down length of first playground is equal to 40 meter. Breadth of first playground is equal to 50 meter and area of first playground we have to find out. We know that area of first playground is equal to length multiplied by breadth. Now put the value 40 meter multiply 50 meter. Now do the multiplication. 40 multiply by 50 we get 2000 and meter multiply by meter we get square meter. So the area of first playground is 2000 square meter. Now we will find out the area of second playground. So write down length of second playground is equal to 75 meter and breadth of second playground is equal to 20 meter and area of second playground we have to find out. We know that area of second playground is equal to length multiplied by breadth. Now put the value 75 meter multiply by 20 meter. Now do the multiplication. 75 multiply by 20 we get 1500 and meter multiply by meter we get square meter. So area of second playground is 1500 square meter and area of first playground is 2000 square meter. Now tell me which playground has bigger area? Yes, first playground. So we see that first playground has bigger area. I hope you all understand area. Thank you. Have a nice day.